In this video, we are going to share a tour plan to the East District of Indian State Sikkim that can be covered in 4 to 5 days for just ₹7,500 per person. Here, we will discuss how to minimize your tour cost after COVID and what are the necessary documents that you should keep with you while visiting. So, without wasting much time, let's get started. The COVID guideline. As I mentioned earlier, currently before we visit any Indian state, we have to follow certain COVID guidelines according to the state rule. To visit Sikkim, you have to carry either a full vaccination report or a RT-PCR report in which the test has been carried 72 hours before your visit. Self-tests are not accepted in Sikkim. The state may not allow you to enter into the premises if you fail to show any one of the above. The train to Sikkim. The train service to the state Sikkim has resumed. The train fare for sleeper class is within ₹700 and for two-tier or three-tier AC coaches, the fare varies between ₹1600 to ₹2600 approximately. Please remember that any conveyance fare is not fixed and may vary due to different reasons. What we are mentioning here is the current rate. Do check the correct ticket price before booking in Railway's official site. I will provide the link in the description box below. The flight to Sikkim. The flight service to the state has also started functioning again. The flight fare varies between ₹1600 to ₹4000 one way, depending upon the season and tourist rush. But here also, we suggest to check the prices before booking as it may change. I will share online booking links in the description box below. The tour. East Sikkim is one of the four districts of Sikkim and occupies the southeast region of the state. The state capital Gangtok falls under this district. Area-wise, it is the smallest of all four districts, but at the same time, it is popular for its diverse scenic beauty. A large area of the southern part of the district is filled with dense Himalayan forest. Other than this, the entire southern part is dotted with many lakes and gushing mountain rivers. As you move towards the north of the district, the surrounding will change from green mountain forest to snow-cladded mountain peaks and snow-covered valleys. No doubt, both are equally enjoyable for its own beauty. And that is the main reason this small district is one of the major tourist attractions of the country. Two mountain passes of East Sikkim are Nathula and Jelepla, which connects Sikkim to China and Bhutan. Due to military activities, visitors to this region are restricted and just a few areas are open to tourists. Things to do in East Sikkim. The famous places to visit in East Sikkim are Zulu, Nathang Valley, Tukla Valley, Lungthang, Thambi Viewpoint, Baba Mandir, and Nathula Pass. From Thambi viewpoint, you can enjoy a spectacular view of the famous zigzag road of Old Silk Route. The spectacular natural glacial lakes Songmo and Kupup or Elephant Lake is also located in this district and the two most visited tourist attractions here. Other than the lakes, you can enjoy the beauty of mountain rivers Tista, Rongpo, Rongli or Reshikhola at this place. All the locations I mentioned till now are part of Old Silk Route, which you can cover in a tour of 4 to 5 days. Remember, only Indian nationals are allowed to visit the Nathula Pass and Baba Mandir and they also need an inner line permit to enter into these regions. You will have to collect your permit one day before you visit there from the authority. Next, you can visit the capital city Gangtok in East Sikkim. The famous places to visit in Gangtok are Ganesh Tok, Tashi Viewpoint, Flower Observatory Center, Bakthang Falls, Banjakri Falls, Rumtek Monastery, and can enjoy a ride of Gangtok Ropeway to get a bird's eye view of the country. Since Gangtok is a modern city, you can take a stroll at the famous MG Marg here and can collect souvenir. But if you want some cheaper options, then the nearby Lal Market is the best place for you. Without visiting the Silk Route, you can also visit Songmo Lake, Baba Mandir and Nathula Pass from Gangtok in a separate tour. You can see animals like yak and red panda at this place. Where to stay? In all the places of Old Silk Route, you will mostly get homestays for night stay. Currently, there are lots of homestays available here which are quite good and can offer all modern amenities. But due to the remote locations, you may not get facilities like television or room heater in your room and geyser in your bathroom. The charges for these homestays varies from ₹1,200 to ₹1,500 per person per day, including food and stay. Since Gangtok is a city, you can get more options for night stay here, ranging from a budget hotel to star category properties where you can expect all modern facilities. The charges of these hotels varies between ₹1,000 to ₹3,000 approximately. Food in Sikkim. In Sikkim, you can find both veg and non-veg food. Though there is a misconception that only non-veg food is available here, but you can also get good quality veg food at this state. If you want to taste local delicacies, then momo and thukpa are two best options. Momos can be of two types, veg or non-veg, and thukpa is a kind of noodle soup which can also be in veg or non-veg form. In non-veg items, you will mostly get chicken or pork. Fish and mutton are rare to find here. Other than momo and thukpa, you can have noodles, rice, dal, veg curry or roti. How to minimize the cost? Before you plan your trip to Sikkim, remember one thing, that the hotel charges and cab fare varies a lot here. It will increase by 1 to 2 thousands of rupees during peak season, which is during October to November and April to May. So, if you are planning to visit at that time, do consider booking hotels and cab at least 2 months before you go there, so that you can get a cheaper rate. If you try to book a hotel right at the time of your visit, then all the hotels and cab will charge much higher, and it is applicable for both online, offline or on-spot bookings, directly or through any agent. Sikkim is beautiful between October and December and late February to early June. Try to avoid visiting during Durga Puja or Diwali and in summer vacation. At that time, the rates are higher and the places are crowded with many tourists. So try to plan your trip in November, December or in March, April to get a cheaper rate and to experience less crowd without compromising with the scenic beauty. In case you don't have these options, then try to book your tour earlier. For any booking related details, please check the description box below. If you love this video, then don't forget to like and share it. Also, do let us know your opinion in the comment section below. Your opinion means a lot to us. Thanks for watching it.